What's up, Vikings? I'm Jesenia.
And I'm Eduardo.
And this is Viking Vision.
Recently, there has been news that vaping is causing severe health issues in teenagers and even death throughout the country. Vaping has become increasingly more popular with teens, yet according to the Surgeon General, e-cigarette use poses a major health risk to young people in the United States. With news almost daily of the dangers of vaping and more teens getting sick from vaping, will teenagers get the message to stop vaping?
Vaping is dangerous because, especially for juveniles, the juvenile brain hasn't completely developed yet, and recent studies for the most part have shown that vaping causes brain damage in addition to respiratory issues.
Users are bound to buy it either way, whether it's bad or not. You know, tobacco's been on for years, you know, smoking, it's known by now, you know, people are gonna buy it, but the people who produce it, and they well knowing, they're profiting off of people being in pain and all that and being addicted to it, so.
There's always backhand methods for underage people to get, drink like alcohol or drugs or stuff like that. So it wouldn't be a really big surprise if there was sort of like a black market for vaping.
Teenagers don't really listen, but I think it should scare them. I understand that they're dangerous, but I think that what they're saying is real.
Oftentimes they vape inside of the restrooms or other little pockets of hiding spots around campus. Some of the consequences are a citation, which in most cases would constitute an arrest. Other consequences could be through like the educational code or ed code, which could lead up to suspension and expulsion.
As of now, I don't think people are rethinking about vaping. It's just kind of one of those things that they get addicted to and they don't really care what others have to say. However, as time goes on, I feel like they will become more aware and start to care about what they're inhaling and ingesting in their body.
Teenagers think that vaping is the new cool and the new, I guess you can say, trend. And they want to be a part of that trend. So even though that they know that there's these risks, they won't really stop because, hey, look, I'm going to be popular because of it.
Thank you guys for the input. It was very interesting to hear different points of view.
Attention seniors. UC and Cal State applications opened up October 1st. Get your personal statements, transcripts, and family income tax reports ready. Applications are due on November 30th.
Also, seniors, fast applications have launched. Make sure to apply ASAP because it works on a first-come, first-served basis. Use this opportunity as a stepping stone for your future. If you need any help, please ask Ms. Arianis in P5 or Ms. Corona in F4.
Hey, fellow gamers. Esports is an increasingly popular activity that is quickly sweeping the nation. Luckily for us, Northview now has an all-new esports team hosted by Mr. Jolliker in B4.
Esports is electronic sports. There are several video games that have been in competition for a while, and they've organized, and now that whole organization falls under the category of esports. Yes, this is a CIF sanctioned sport. Last year was the first year that it was recognized as a sport, and which they're calling year zero, so this will be year one. And there's a big enough presence with esports, and it started at the colleges, and CIF saw an opportunity to bring it to the high schools and make it kind of an official competition. I think it came to be just from having fans and a lot of people liking to watch the competition so much that they had official organizations kind of take charge and make it official. The esport game that we're going to cover this season for the fall season is called Rocket League, which is a form of digital soccer. Instead of players, we're going to have cars that will be used to kick the ball. When we start having matches and we get things running, we're hoping to have it set up in a way that people can come and watch and kind of participate and cheer on. We're looking at also getting an announcer and having a social media presence and really trying to grow the awareness of what's going on here. Practices will be in B4 as of right now, and matches will be on Thursdays after school.
What a great addition to our campus. Good luck to all of Northview's competitors. Now, here's Destiny with news on fall sports.
What's up, Vikings? My name's Destiny, and welcome back to VVSN. Our girls volleyball team is still killing it, taking a win against Baldwin Park in a 5-set match. Keep up the good work, ladies. Our boys football team is back and better than ever, taking a win against Wilson High School with an incredible score of 56-6. Our Spirit of Northview did amazing this last Saturday, taking third place with a score of 57.25. Keep up the amazing work. That's it for sports, Vikings. Now to Jesenia and Eduardo.
That's all the time we have for today. Remember, Vikings, good life.
Good life.
Catch you later. She filled my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. She saw my eyes, she know I'm